It is time for the Goodyear Mudbash and all the races that encapsulate this race, as we have the four heat races coming up along with the last chance qualifier, and then you get to the main event, the Goodyear Mudbash. So, four 10-lap heat races with nine drivers in each of them. The top five in each of those heat races move on to the main event. That means we'll have 20 drivers right there locked in. It's a 30-man event, which means we have 10 spots open for 16 drivers in the last chance qualifier. Another 10-lap event where the top four finishers make it in, and then the top six highest in points after that make it into the event, and then we have six drivers that get left out without a shot at the victory in the Goodyear Mudbash. So heat number one starts with Trey Rand on the pole in the 98, outside second, Ashton Boyd, the 20 truck. Then third, we have Anthony Hernandez, fourth, Riley Spurrier-Tube, fifth, it's William Seaman, sixth, Priya McShane, seventh, we have Jose Mills, eighth, Bobby Frazier, in ninth place, it's Levi Jones in the 40 car. So, the field going to be rolling off the starting grid right here for 10 laps of action in heat number one. And it's going to be Trey Rain and Ashton Boyd on the front row. There go the nine trucks rolling off the starting grid. And while these are heat races and you only use them to really get into the event, they've been no short of craziness in the past. We've seen a lot of crazy heat races here for this Goodyear Mudbash. So, whoever wins this heat race starts on the pole for the main event. We'll see who gets it. Trey Rain, Ashton Boyd, front row. Green flag for 10 laps in heat one. Trey Rainey from the pole. He'll lead lap one of the heat. Hernandez to the inside will grab second away. Here's the transfer spot. Jose Mills moves by Riley Spurrier, who falls back in the outside lane. Levi Jones trying to get there in the 40 truck. Down the back of the race. Hernandez looks for the lead on Trey Rain as they come off turn number four. Back around to the start-finish line. Trey up the racetrack. Hernandez to the inside. They battle side-by-side for the lead. The transfer spot is a battle. Levi Jones to the inside. Boyd to the outside. They race side-by-side for the last spot in the heat. Hernandez going to get by Trey Rain to move to the front. Mills for third. Here comes Jones, trying to get by Seaman. And here's a big battle right there. Jones gets a fourth. Here's the battle for fifth. Seaman, Boyd, and Frazier. Boyd now has it to go three wide. Trey Rain wants to get clear that. You don't want to be up top three wide here at Eldora. They go three wide for P3. Ashlyn Boyd on the inside gets it. Jones to fourth. The battle's for fifth. Trey Rain to the outside. He's starting on pole, but Seaman to the inside. He'll grab the fifth position away off turn two. Seaman down the transfer spot. Can Trey Rain do anything with them? Now watch for that. Levi Jones up the racetrack. The 40 truck now back to fifth. He's back in the transfer spot. This is the fight to get in through heat one. At the front of the field, Hernandez and Mills have pulled away. Here's the battle for fifth. It's a three-way battle. Trey Rain gets it over Jones, but here comes Frazier hot on his tail. Bobby Frazier not letting that 98 get away as they come off turn four. Back around to see four laps to go. Frazier to the inside of Trey. They battle side by side. Frazier gets fifth. Now Trey's back to sixth. He started on pulling this heat. Can he somehow find a way around? He goes really wide that time. Frazier gets way in fifth. Back at the front, Hernandez deletes Jose Mills. And no real battles at the front. Battles for sixth. Jones to the inside, Trey Rainey. Three laps remain in Eldora. Heat race number one. Already crazy. Frazier holds the transfer spot. But is anyone able to make a charge? You get to Frazier late. The 14 slips wide a little bit. Spurrier to making a late race charges. Jones gets the outside wall hard. 40 bouncing around. Spurrier to sixth. Can he get to Bobby Frazier? A lap and a half. For third as well. Seaman on the back of Ashton. Boy, that could be a good battle brewing up. They're also going to be balanced for second because Mills is dropping back to them. Hernandez takes the white flag. We're on the final lap in heat number one. Anthony Hernandez is going to win the first heat and start on the pole in the main event. Ashton Boyd gets to second. Mills back to third. Seaman is going to be fourth. Fifth place is Bobby Frazier. Through the final corner, checkered flag in the air. Anthony Hernandez wins heat number one. Here at Eldora, Boyd second, Seaman third, Mills fourth, and Bobby Frazier the last driver to advance in fifth. Spurrier in sixth will go through the last chance qualifier. Same with Trey Rainey in seventh. Eighth for Priya McShane as well. And ninth for Levi Jones. So those are the five drivers that are going to advance and the four that will go through the last chance qualifier. Let's now go and see heat number two of the race. Here's how the nine truck field for Heat number two of the Goodyear Mudbash lines up. Danny Lloyd on pole for this heat. Outside in second, the Ford truck of Landon Lyons. In third, it's Marshall Burrow. Fourth, it's Damian Blue. Fifth place, we have Riley Snare. Then sixth, it's Jack Cannaramo. Seventh, we have Mathis Wells. Eighth, Justin Zeidel. Running off the field, ninth, Mitchell Collins in the 74 truck. So the field will roll off right here. Danny Lloyd and Landon Lyons leading the way. Remember, the top five in each heat advance through to the main event. The winner of this heat will start the main event in the second position. So top five advance for the last four will move on to the last chance qualifier to try and make their way in through there. 10 laps heat number two, we're green flag racing at Eldora. Danny Lloyd, the winner of this race last season, and a photo finish, will lead lap one of his heat. For fifth, they got all jammed up. Mathis Wells got clear in the 51. Down in front of the 74, Mitchell Collins, who started this heat race last. Battles on for second. Riley Snare gets it from Marshall Burrow. Mathis Wells moving to third. That's the battle for transfer spot. Mitchell Collins up by Landon Lyons. The 84 goes really wide, and Burrow's going to fall back on the outside. Lyons to his inside. He grabs fifth away. Zeidel to the bottom lane. Hard charge for the 29. He'll get the fifth off turn two. Justin Zeidel to the transfer spot. Down the back, he'll look for fourth. Big run for that 29. He's get by Mitchell Collins to that 29. Give himself some padding. Try to make sure he doesn't fall out. That 29 looks pretty fast. He got up inside the top two right here. Side by side front. Zeidel looks three wide on the 51, the 63. They slide off the corner. Lyons gets a fifth over Collins. Look at Justin Zeidel, that hard charge he had. But now he's kind of stalled out behind those two. He'll move by Riley Snare as the 63 gets the wall. Moves Zeidel to third. Now the battle for fifth. Burrow gets over Lyons again. But now Riley Snare might fall back into fifth. That 63 on the outside falling back. Daniel Lloyd's led every lap so far in this heat event. Riley Snare falling back in the outside. Here comes Landon Lyons the four to the inside. Well, that's going to be close for fifth. Lyons gets it from Snare. Now can Damian Blue do anything with Jack Harrow and Mitchell Collins as well? Burrow moves on Wells for second. Zeidel now going to fall back to fifth as Lyons moves to the inside. Burrow's going to move to second, the 84. Danny Lloyd pops the wall and falls back. Can you hold on for four laps and just stay in the top five? Burrow's going to get the lead, it looks like. For fifth, Zeidel on the outside, Blue on the inside. They bounce side by side down the back. Marshall Burrow takes the lead in heat number two. Wells will move to second. Now Wells for the lead. Lloyd's going to want to get clear in front of Lyons. He does just that. Now Mathis Wells to the front. They're wrecking to the back. A truck is upside down. Caution flag. The battle for fifth is on. Blue has it. Can Zeidel get there? In the final corner, heat number two, checkered flag is waving. Winner of it will be Mathis Wells. Lloyd will be second. Marshall Burrow third, Lyons in fourth, and Damian Blue will advance in fifth. Zeidel, the first man down in sixth, and then the damage trucks. Riley Snare in seventh will not advance. Mitchell Collins in eighth, and Jack Cannaramo in ninth. So we know the five drivers that will advance. Mathis Wells, Danny Lloyd, Marshall Burrow, Landon Lyons, and Damian Blue. Zeidel, the first man out in sixth, was the only actual driver to not make the race that was not in that crash. Snare, Collins, and Jack Cannaramo, all three of them crashed. We'll have to see how that happened. But the white flag is out. Final lap for Mathis Wells. In all likelihood, he's going to win heat number two and start second in the main event, the Goodyear Mudbash. So as they coast, and somehow, some way, all those trucks are still running, all of them that were involved in the crash, because it looked like at least one of them was up in the air, maybe not upside down, but it looked like one or two of them got air under the wheels of that truck. But as they come through three and four, Mathis Wells is going to take the checkered flag, and he's going to win heat number two of the Goodyear Mudbash. So Mathis Wells will have a good starting position as the 51 takes the checkered flag. He's the winner here in heat number two. So let's see what happened out the yellow flag to end heat number two early. This was a three-way battle for seventh. This was outside the transfer spot. Jack Cannaramo, Riley Snare, Mitchell Collins. These guys were really kind of far off the pack, so it didn't really look like one of them was going to have a chance to advance. Right here, Cannaramo gets the wall. Riley Snare comes up into him. They make contact. 63 goes down, basically onto what you would call the apron here. Then back up, and he's going to get Jack Cannaramo, Mitchell Collins. Those three go spinning into the outside wall. And right there, there's the truck that went off the ground, the 63 Snare. And Collins spins around as well in the 74 truck. So it's our second. It's our first yellow flag here in heat number two. First yellow flag of the night. We might see some more later on, especially in that last chance qualifier. 10 laps to get those positions. Slide there and wiping out those three drivers. And Collins almost had missed. They have some damage. They should be able to repair it, though. This is a dirt track. Not much aerodynamics required here. So get those trucks repaired and get right up to the front there in the last chance qualifier. Mathis Wells beats the field back to win heat number two. Let's now go see heat number three for the Goodyear Mud Bash. Here's the lap for the third heat of the Goodyear Mud Bash. Devon Wren, the 10, has won the pole for this heat. Outside second, Jamie Stanmore Jr. in the 68. In third, Madison Tall. Fourth, Tim Randolph. Walker Davis running out the top five. Then Casey Nacko in sixth. Seventh for Griffin Lynn. One of two races he'll run this season in the one truck. In eighth place, we have Ray Stern running out the field. Ninth, it's Danny Bright in the 02. So the field going to roll off the starting grid right here. Nine truck field for heat number three. Once again, the top five advance. Sixth through ninth go through the last chance qualifier. So right now, Walker Davis has the final transfer spot, but 10 laps to figure it out here in heat number three. We saw our first yellow flag of the night in heat number two. Pretty tame heat number one. What's heat number three going to be like as we take the green flag? We're racing heat number three, the Goodyear Mud Bash. Devon Wren gets away. Madison Tall is going to get to second in turn one. How about Madison Tall? It's a great jump there. The 33 moves to second. Walker Davis on the inside. Look at Danny Bright rubbing with Ray Serback there already. Eighth and ninth fall off greatly because they were rubbing off each other. Devon Red from the pole, lead lap one, heat three. Madison Tall to second. Walker Davis attacking for that position. Lynn gets to fourth, three wide for fifth. Nacko may give him the bumper to Randolph. Sandwich Jr. up against the wall. Three wide for the transfer spot down the back into turn three. Nacko on the inside, gonna take it away. Nacko moves to fifth. Randolph now sixth. Griffin Lynn gets away. Walker Davis can move to second by Madison Tall. Now is a good charge on Devon Red for the race lead in turn three. Winner of this heat starts third in the main event. Walker Davis to the inside of Devon Red. They go side by side. Red leads the lap. Davis to the inside in turn one. He'll take the lead away. Bow for fourth. It looks like Casey Nacko going to try and put Griffin Lynn to the back. Yeah, Nacko wants a buffer in case something does happen. 50 truck can move to fourth, put Griffin Lynn in the bubble. So now Linda fifth in the transfer spot. Look at Ray Sir. He'll charge by Danny Bright as the 02 got the wall. Sir now to sixth. Madison Tall and Walker Davis for the lead down the back. Side by side for the top spot, heat three. All these yards really wanting to get the win and start third. It's a great starting position here at Eldora. Five laps remain in the heat. Right now, the transfer spot is held by Griffin Lynn by a good margin. They're side-by-side for sixth, slowing each other down. Lynn's away in fifth and a nice distance away. The front four have gotten away as Casey Nacko joins the party at the front. Lynn goes up the racetrack. If he gets into the wall, he almost did. He didn't quite do it there. Four laps remaining in the heat. Can Griffin Lynn hold on? Can Randolph or Stanworth get up there and challenge him? They go side-by-side for sixth, down the back to turn three. Griffin Lynn's loving that. He's pulling away three wide for a second. Nacko forces to the bottom of the racetrack, but the 10 gets clear in the middle. Three laps left. Nacko still trying to get to second. What a great charge for the 50 truck late. Nacko moves to third by Walker Davis. Now good look for a second on Rez Massetal. Pulls away in the lead. For fifth, Stanworth's gotten clear in sixth and has two laps to run Lynn down. It's going to be a challenge, but the one keeps messing up in these corners, obviously not handling right. Lynn up the racetrack. Again, Stanworth closes in. It could be a last lap duel. Devon Redford, second, goes way up the track. Casey Nacko to the bottom. We'll look for a second off turn four. White flag, last lap in the heat. Stanworth on the back of Griffin Lynn. Can the 68 make the move on the one and force Lynn into the last chance qualifier? Remember, the one doesn't have the points to balance for a second. Nacko's going to get it. Madison Tall come off the corner and take the checkered flag and win the battle for fifth. Lynn and Stanworth checkered flag. Lynn gets fifth, Stanworth in sixth. And Nacko got second. So Nacko powers through to second. Madison Tall wins and will start third in the main event. And the drivers going through the last chance qualifier. Jamie Stanworth Jr., Tim Randolph, Danny Bright, and Ray Sir. Three crazy heats. Let's go to the final heat. Heat number four. 10-lap event. And then we'll go to the last chance qualifier. Here's the starting lap for our final heat of the night, heat number four. This will determine the last five drivers to advance through the heats, and then the rest of the drivers that will go on through the last chance qualifier. Leanne Campana on pole for this heat. In second, it's Sebastian Kukla on the 31. Third wave, Michael Gregory. Fourth, Mark Silas. Rang out the top five, Alex Fletcher. Sixth place, Ryan Brommer. Seventh, Bronson Minnick. Eighth for Isaac Nichols. And rang out the heat field in ninth, Diego Yepes in the 99 truck. So these nine drivers are going to be rolling off the starting grid to start the final heat of the night. Heat number four in the Goodyear Mudbash. Winner of this heat will start fourth in the main event. So Leon Kapan on pole, Sebastian Kukulon to his outside. Who are the final five drivers through in the heats? Who are the other four that will go through the last chance qualifier? 10 laps in heat four. Green flag for the final heat of the night. Campana, nice jump there. Kukulon, pretty good jump as well. Brommer goes up the racetrack. Fletcher holds fifth for now. Down the back they race. Off to three. Gregory inside Kukulon. Gonna grab that second spot away. So Michael Gregory to second on lap one. Capon gets through to the lead. For fifth, Mark Sattles at the racetrack, and Bronson Minnick holds the transfer spot now. So now Minnick to the top five. He's in. Now Kukulon's on the outside, falling back. With Minnick looking to the inside, that's going to put Kukulon back to fifth. Minnick up to fourth. And Fletcher on Michael Gregory for P2. Oh, look at that checkup right there. The 07 and the 88 made some contact. And Minnick goes three wide to get to second. Back there, some contact. They look four wide. Contact! Silas and Nichols rub. 19 still down low on Kukulon. Oh, crazy heat so far. Kukulon on the outside is fifth. Michael Gregory trying to keep a top five. 19 moves to fifth. Isaac Nichols to the transfer spot. And now Michael Gregory going to fall back in the 11. Gregory now back to fifth as Nichols moves to fourth. Kukulon going to look for fifth back on Michael Gregory. Side by side for the transfer spot. Kukulon inside Gregory to turn one. And the 31 takes fifth right back. Yepes, the 99, looks low for sixth on Gregory as the 11 goes wide. Back up at the front. Pulling away, Leon Kapana gets away from the man that's behind. Minnick away in second, Fletcher away in third. The battle's on for fourth. Nichols to the outside, Kukulon to the inside. Kukulon back up to fourth, Nichols back to fifth, and in the transfer spot. But it's Diego Yepes to the inside of the 99. Hard charge off turn two and slides it sideways. Yepes wheeling that truck, trying to get there inside the top five. And right here through three and four, yes, the inside's going to take it. Nichols goes up the racetrack, and Yepes at the start finish line with four to go moves to fifth. Yepes to the top five as at the front, Minnick in a hard charge trying to get to Capon to win the heat. Oh, he overstepped his boundaries though. Went at the racetrack. Here's the battle for fifth. Yepes, Nichols, and Brommer. Who do you have? Yepes got the wall with three to go. Nichols and Brommer go to the inside. Three wide for the transfer spot. What do Silas and Gregory do now because they see three wide in front? Do they think they'll make it? Ryan Brommer moves to fifth. And a three wide pass. Is that the pass that gets him the transfer spot? Two to go. Battle's on for second. Fletcher approaching Bronson Meg for that spot, but the main battle's for fifth right here. Because Isaac Nichols is not going to let Brommer get away. You know that for sure. White flag last lap from Leon Kapan. The 20 has dominated. He's going to lead every lap and win the heat. But here's the battle for fifth, the battle that matters. This is the last transfer spot. Brommer has it. Nichols wants it. What does Nichols do in three and four? Back to the line. Leon Capano's won the race. Here's the battle for fifth. Brommer on the outside. Nichols on the inside. Drag racing back and Ryan Brommer gets fifth. Brommer advances through in the 08. Capano wins. He'll start fourth. Minnick second. Fletcher third. Kukulon fourth. Brommer in fifth. The drivers go through the last chance qualifier. Isaac Nichols, Mark Silas, Michael Gregory, and Diego Yepes. So we know the 20 drivers that are through the heats. Now let's go see how the last chance qualifier goes. 16 drivers going for 10 spots in the LCQ. This is the last chance for these 16 drivers to advance through to the main event, the Goodyear Mudbash. This is the last chance qualifier for season number 7, Goodyear Mudbash in the Pennzoil Truck Series. Once again, the way to get through, top four finishers, no matter where they are in points, advance. The last six spots go to the top six in points that did not advance. So all these drivers have rankings in the points, and some of them are automatically locked in because of their point rankings. Other people need to get through in the top four no matter what. They cannot rely on their point situation. Mitchell Collins in the 74 has gotten the pole for this last chance qualifier. He's eighth on the points. No matter what he does, he'll be into the Goodyear Mudbash later tonight. Second place, Premier McShane, the 25, is gonna need some help. 33rd in points coming in, needs to finish inside the top four. fourth place, Jack Canaramo, comes in 20th in the point standings. He can advance either way. He can hope that the top four finishers in this race are the top, or four of the top drivers in points, and then he can get through, or just finish top four in points to make it easier on himself. And in fourth place, we have Michael Gregory, comes in sixth in points, so he's safe no matter what. And rounding out the top five, Riders for the 35, comes in 34th in points, the lowest of anyone in this race. He needs to be top four to race in the main event. Sixth place, Diego Yepez, comes in third in points, so he's safe no matter what. Seventh place, Mark Silas, comes in 23rd in points. He's just like Jack Cameron. He can do whatever he wants and hope that he can advance. Riley Snair in 8th, the 63, 31st in points, needs to finish top 4. 9th place, Trey Rainey comes in 12th in the point standings, so he's safe as well. He's one of the top 6 in points. And rounding out the top 10, Danny Bright, the 02, comes in 27th in points. He needs to finish top 4. Rest of the field in 11th, Tim Roth, the 94. He comes in 14th in points, just like the 82 and the 15. He can try and advance through to the top 4, but he can also fall back in his points ranking if everything goes right. In 12th, Levi Jones, the 40 truck, 24th in points, just like Tim Renoff. He can fall back on his points if needed. Jamie Stanford Jr. in 68 comes in as the points leader, so he's automatically into the main event no matter what. To his outside is Ray Sir in the 13th. Sir comes in 28th in points, so he also needs to finish top 4 in points. And the two teammates are Justin Zidell and Isaac Nichols. Zidell comes in the points, standing 7th in points, so he's good to make it in. But for his teammate Isaac Nichols, who starts in the last position, Nichols needs some help. He comes in 29th in points. He needs to go from 16th starting position to inside the top 4 to make it in. So there's our starting lineup for last chance qualifier for season 7 of the Pennzoil Truck Series Goodyear Mudbash. Let's get these trucks going. As the field is energized, the fans are energized. We're going to get going here at the Goodyear Mudbash in Eldora, the last chance qualifier. So just like the heats, a 10-lap event this time, though, we've almost doubled the amount of trucks in it. 9 trucks in each heat, this time 16 trucks. Who's going to advance through? Can someone pull a miracle like Riley Sproul, YouTuber, Danny Breyer, Brace, served Isaac Nichols? Drivers that need miracles to happen. 10 laps, last chance qualifier is green. Premix Shane got a great jump there and beat Collins to the start finish on 74. It's going to take it back, though. Here comes Canaramo and Sproul, YouTuber, 3 and 4 wide, further back in the pack. Drivers trying to move forward, they are 4 wide, further back in the field. They short back to 3 wide. Justin Zidell carving a way through the field, trying to get his teammate up there with them. Lap 1. It is Mitchell Collins leading it. Canaramo goes to 2nd. Riley Sproul needs to finish top 4. He moves right to 3rd. Sproul needs to stay up here. Remember, top 4 advance. The other 6 spots filled by points. Sproul can't get filled in by points. He's the 16th driver in points of these drivers. Here comes Canaramo looking at Mitchell Collins with 8 to go. These are the 4 that would advance. And right now it'd be Collins, Canaramo, Sproul, YouTube, and Mark Silas. Randolph up to 5th. Stanworth comes in as the points leader. He's in no matter what, but he just wants a better starting position. He's moving forward to 68. Canaramo looked at Collins, got a little tight and let off. Now Riley Sproul, YouTube looks to the back of the 15. If I'm Sproul, YouTube, and I'm in the top 4 spot, do I dare want to get by that 15 to get a buffer and potentially get into some altercations? Look to the inside. He'll get to P2 off turn 4. So Riley Sproul to 2nd. Canaramo back to 3rd, now to 4th, as Mark Silas jumps inside the A2 truck. And Sproul to is hunting for the lead. Mark Silas moves to 3rd. Jack Canaramo back to 4th, now in the 15. Dangerous spot for him to be in, because he cannot fall back on his points. He needs a lot to go right if he wants to fall back on his points position. Zidell trying to get there, Jamie Stanmore Jr. So they come off the corner. It is still Collins leading the race from the pole position. Riley Sproul to rides in 2nd with Mark Silas in 3rd. And now for 4th, Canaramo falling back off the front 3, back to the clutches of Tim Randolph, the 94. Here comes Trey Rainey forward with Diego Yepez. A lot of drivers are in no matter what, based off their points, they're starting to come forward. As into the wall for Collins, our race leader. 4 laps remain. Winner of this race starts 21st in the race. That's a big difference from starting 30th. Down the back. Mitchell Collins leading the way, come to 3 to go. Riley Sproul in pursuit. 3 laps remain in Eldora. Right now, this is working out great for the 35. He needed to get in the top 4. Currently rides in 2nd. For Mark Stiles and Mitchell Collins, they could have fallen back on their points. Same with Jack Cameron, who rides in 4th. But Trey Rainey in 5th. Gonna try and knock that 15 out. Trey Rainey is in no matter what. Can he knock Cameron out? 2 laps remain in the last chance qualifier. Mitchell Collins, the 74. Out in front as Sproul goes up the racetrack, the 35. He drops back. Sproul just has to be patient here. He doesn't need that win. He'll start 22nd if he finishes right there. Last lap of the last chance qualifier, Mitchell Collins is going to lead all 10 laps, it looks like, en route to victory. Jack Cameron holds fourth down, and right now in a great position to make it as they enter the final corners. Mitchell Collins is going to win the event. Riley Spurgeon in second. Cameron flies to third, and Mark Sattler is fourth. Those four will advance through. Who gets in on points? So Collins is in. Spurgeon is in. Cameron will in. Mark Silas in. Now the question is, which six drivers going on points? We'll go look at the finishing results for that. And we see right there. So Mitchell Collins makes it in. Riley Spurgeon makes it in. Jack Cameron makes it in. Mark Silas makes it in. Only one of those drivers was locked in on points. That was Mitchell Collins, who won the event. Sprotube needed to finish inside the top four. He did just that. Jack Cameron and Mark Silas could have fallen back on their points if necessary. However, they made their way in, and they made it a definite to get in. Fifth place, Trey Rainey advances through. Diego Yepes in sixth. He'll advance through because of his point standing. Justin Zidell, he'll advance through. Look down at the rest. Another driver, Jamie Stanworth Jr., he's advanced through no matter what. Michael Gregory will advance through no matter what. That means which of the drivers that I did not list right there, which of them is highest in points that was not locked in? That answer goes to Tim Randolph in the 94, who finished in the ninth position, 14th in points for him. Other drivers that needed to somehow get in, Levi Jones in 24th. Obviously would not have worked for him. Riley Snare, 31st. Danny Bright, 27th. So all those drivers that I did not name. Ray Sir will not advance through. Pre-Mix Shane does not advance. Levi Jones does not advance. Isaac Nichols does not advance. Danny Bright does not advance. And Riley Snare does not advance. That means we know the 30-truck field for the season number 7 Goodyear Mudbash Eldora. Join us later tonight for 20 laps of action around this dirt racetrack in Ohio. I'll see you guys then. It is time for the main event of the weekend. This is the Pennzoil Truck Series Eldora, the main event, 30 trucks. This is the Goodyear Mud Bash. Four heats, one last chance qualifier, 50 laps in those events. Has now come down to 23 laps in the main event to determine the overall winner of the Goodyear Mud Bash for Season 7. Winner of heat number one, Anthony Hernandez has won the pole for the 23 in tonight's race. Outside second is the winner of heat number two, Mathis Wells on the 51. Then third's winner of heat three, Madison Tall. Fourth place winner of heat four, Leon Capana. Rounding out the top five is Ashton Boyd in the 20 truck. 6th place, we have Danny Lloyd, winner of this race last season by 2/1000ths of a second. In 7th place, we have Casey Nanico. 8th for Bronson Minnick. In 9th, it's William Steeman. And rounding out the top 10, Marshall Burrell in the 84 truck. The rest of the field is Walker Davis. Outside of him, the 07 of Alex Fletcher. And we have Jose Mills with landlines in the 4 truck. Behind them, Devon Redd and Sebastian Kukulon, the 31, with Damian Blue and Bobby Frazier, the 14, with Griffin Lynn, one of two races he'll run this season. Outside of him, Ryan Brommer in the 08 truck. Then we have Mitchell Collins and Riley Spurlitube, with Mark Silas and Jack Cannaramo. Then there's Diego Yepes and Trey Rainey, Tim Randolph and Justin Zidell. And then the final row, rounding out the field in 29th position, it is points leader Jamie Stammer Jr. And in 30th, rounding out the field, Michael Gregory in the 11 truck. The 6 drivers that failed to qualify for this event: Pre McShane, Levi Jones, Riley Snare, Danny Bright Racer, and Isaac Nichols. But the show must go on without them. 30 drivers do battle here at Eldora for the Goodyear Mud Bash in Season 7. Let's go on track and fire these truck engines up for racing on the dirt track in Ohio.
Drivers, start your engines!
All 30 trucks rolling off the starting grid to get the main event underway. The Goodyear Mud Bash in Eldora. It's a 23-lap event, dirt racing, which means these trucks are going to be sliding. Track position very huge, and starting on the inside as well is very, very important. 23 laps in the Goodyear Mud Bash Eldora. Green flag in the air, we're racing. The winner of heat number one, Anthony Harris, comes off turn four and leads the first lap of the Goodyear Mud Bash. Mazatol in pursuit to turn one, looking to the inside, but gets tight. Ashlyn Boyd looks low. To the bottom of the racetrack for P2. Ashlyn Boyd, Mazatol. Tall gets away on the top side to get clear for a second. Hernandez going to come around and lead the second lap. Casey Nanico comes to fourth with Seaman for fifth. Yellow flag on lap two. It's our first one of the night. It's a crash in 3 and 4, involving drivers that got through in the last chance qualifier. Jack Cannaramo, Landon Lines may have involved. Kukulon on the 31. There's Mark Stiles. Looks like he has some damage in the 82 truck. It's our first yellow of the main event here tonight, and it happens early on. Jack Cannaramo, one of them involved in the 15 truck. Early yellow flag as crazy racing happened at the back of the field. They're 3 and 4 wide, almost like Daytona and Talladega. They're stacked up 3 and 4 wide in a pack. As they come off turn number 2, Landlines gets up into the side of Alex Fletcher. They make contact. 4 comes down, 15 comes up. They meet in the middle. Around goes the 4 of Landlines. Comes up, Jack Cameron gets Sebastian Kukulon, who gets heavy damage. Mark Sanders plows through, but he gets damage. Ryan Brommer and Riley Spurlitube are able to somehow find a way through the mess sideways. They saved their trucks and got away, but the big contact was Cannaramo, Kukulon, and Landon Lyons. Luckily for them, though, it's a dirt track. Not much aerodynamics required here. This should be, if not up to speed, not too slow. Just aggressive racing early on, trying to get every spot you can. Getting close to, every driver, 3-4 wide racing, and it turned into that, as we saw right there. Kukulon probably got the most damage with some front-end damage right there. Anthony Nez, like seeing that, he's racking up the lap sled bonus points as he's out in front, the 23 truck, looking to lead them back to the green flag and our first restart to Goodyear Mud Bash. Coming back to the green flag on lap number 8, Anthony Nez leads the way in the 23 truck. All 30 trucks still left on the racetrack and on the lap, and the 23 heat number 1 winner leads them around here at Eldora. Second place, we have Madison Tall. Third for Ashlyn Boyd. Casey Nanico to fourth, and William Seaman fifth. Then Matthew Swell sixth. Leon Campana seventh. Eighth for Walker Davis. Ninth, Jose Mills. And Bronson Mick inside the top 10. Back green, and the Goodyear Mud Bash Hernandez gets away on the jump. Madison Tall keeps second. They're single file back through the field. The first move out of line, Seaman on Nanico for fourth. Bears it to the bottom of the racetrack. The 05 does. Side by side with Nanico. Back behind them, shoving up. Campana and Wells made some contact. Walker Davis goes 3 wide in the 8 truck. 3 wide inside the top 10. That's for 6th. Make it 5th as Nanico goes way wide. And the 50's going to fall back as 8. And then 28 go to the inside. 3 wide for the top 5 spot. Off into 3. Jose Mills jumping low. Danny Lloyd behind in the 17 truck. Davis comes out the corner. Gets the position for Nanico. They're 3 wide behind them still. At the front, bow for the liaison. Tall to the inside, Fernandez. And she'll take it. Madison Tall to the front in Eldora. Ashlyn Boyd for second on Anthony Nez, putting that 23 up top. And Madison Tall gets away. Boyd's going to get to second the 20 truck. toggles up the racetrack, almost into the wall. Boy, that's a nice run to turn one. Look into the inside. Right to the back bumper, gets a little tight right there and couldn't make the move. Three trucks break away for the lead. Tall Boyd and Hernandez. And the yellow flag is back out for the second time. Mitchell Collins has crashed. Looks like Jose Mills may have been in that as well. Yellow flag is out. Some trucks have got the wall racing back to the yellow. Madison Tall with the lead. It's our second yellow flag of the race. We're only on lap number 12. Let's go see what happened to this caution as the winner of the LCQ, Mitchell Collins, has crashed heavily. Jose Mills running inside the top 10 when this occurred as he comes off turn 4. He's behind Casey Nack on the 50 truck. Gets a little wide. 50 gets into the wall. Comes down. Mills is there. Spins the 54 around in front of the field. Frazier gets some contact right there. Spins the 54 back up the racetrack into teammate Mathiswell, so has nowhere to go. Hard contact for the two of them. Mills spins down the racetrack after more contact with the 51. And Mitchell Collins comes down the outside and just nails the 54 hard, spinning Collins up into the outside wall. Everyone else getting low and getting by, but it's our second yellow flag of the Goodyear Mudbash, and we're not even halfway done when the second yellow flag came out. We will be halfway done once we get back green. Some long caution laps here and making it a shorter race for sure, not, you know, less green flag racing, and get through this race pretty quickly as of now. Mitchell Collins gets heavy damage in the 74 truck. Racing it back around, Madison Tall led the field back to our second yellow flag of the night. She's staying on the racetrack. She'll lead Ashlyn Boyd and the rest of the field back to the green flag. It will be 7 laps of racing to go once we get back green here at Eldora and the Goodyear Mudbash. Mitchell Collins taking his truck to the garage, so he's done for the night. Ryan Brommer and Jack Cameron are both a lap down and off the pace. 27 trucks are on the lead lap for this restart. Madison Tall out in front of the 33, trying to control the rest of the race. Ashton Boyd runs in second, third for Anthony Nez, fourth for Walker Davis, Nan Capana in fifth, and William Simon, Danny Lloyd, Casey Nackle, Bobby Frazier, and Bronson Mick inside the top 10 as we're back green, and Tall gets away. Great jump for the 33. That could be what she needed as well. It's hard to pass here. She could have just locked up the win right there with that great move. Back behind them, they look three wide. Bobby Frazier and Bronson Mick almost spinning there. Minnick drives to the inside to go three wide, puts the 14th to racetrack alone. Nack on the 50. Alex Fletcher gonna get inside the top 10 with this move in the 07 truck. Up ahead, Lloyd charging through the field to fifth for the 17 and for the lead. Ashlyn Boyd over the back of Madison Tall. They're coming to 5 to go in the Goodyear Mudbash. Tall goes up the racetrack. Boyd looks inside. Off of 4, back to the start finish line. Tall leads, but Ashlyn Boyd takes it with 5 to go. Look at Leanne Capana in third gaining. Here comes Danny Lloyd, winner last season in this race. Up to 4th and gaining fast. Tall's clear. Ashlyn Boyd gets away. Capana goes up the racetrack loose. And Danny Lloyd's going to take advantage to get to third. Lloyd to P3 has 4 laps to get by the 33 and the 20. Seaman to fifth, get by Hernandez, who falls. Becky starting on pole. Alex Fletcher to the top 10, the 07. But the battle's at the front of the field. Ashlyn Boyd leads the race but goes wide through 3 and 4. Madison Tall's down lower. Boyd gets the wall. Here comes Madison Tall to run with 3 to go. Danny Lloyd dropped back there, side by side for third. Two trucks break away for the win. Ashlyn Boyd opened up a gap over Madison Tall. Coming to 2 to go this time. Tall again lower. Boyd higher. Off of 4. 2 laps remain. The Goodyear Mudbash at Eldora. Ashlyn Boyd leads the way. Madison Tall in pursuit in 1 and 2. Mangapon third. The battle's for 4th. Lloyd outside. Walker Davis inside. Before the race win. About 2 truck lengths separate the 20 and the 33 as they come out turn 4. The white flag is in the air. Last lap at Eldora for Ashlyn Boyd. Madison Tall went wide. That's all Ashlyn Boyd needs. Pulling ahead for Ashlyn Boyd. Down the back for the final time and into turn 3. Out front the right time. Ashlyn Boyd will come out turn 4 and get the victory on the dirt. Ashlyn Boyd wins the Goodyear Mudbash in Eldora. Tall, Davis, and others come across the start finish line, but the night belongs to Ashlyn Boyd, winning the Goodyear Mudbash for Season 7 in Eldora. Let's go see the finishing results from a crazy race in Eldora. Here's how they finished in the Goodyear Mudbash at the Eldora Speedway. We had 2 caution flags in this race for 10 laps and 2 lead changes, 3 different driving laps here today in Eldora, as it's Ashlyn Boyd reigning supreme, leading 5 laps, with probably the final 5 laps en route to victory on the dirt. Second place for Madison Tall, tied for the most laps out of 9, but it was just too short to make a run at Ashlyn Boyd. For third, it was Walker Davis. Fourth, Leon Campana, and William Seaman rounds out the top five. Danny Lloyd, a great backup to the win last season, ends up in sixth here tonight. Alex Fletcher, with a late charge, gets up to seventh. Bronson Mack in eighth. Casey Nacko ninth. And Anthony Adams from the pole at the first nine laps, so fell back and barely ends up inside the top 10. Damian Blue ends up in 11th, Michael Gregory 12th, Bobby Frazier 13th, 14th, Justin Zeidel, Marshall Burrow in 15th. Jamie Stammers Jr. Retains that point with a 16th place after starting back in 29th, so a great recovery for this 68 here tonight. Griffin Lynn in 17th, Trey Rainey 18th, Sebastian Kuechel on 19th, and Devon Redd, rounds out the top 20. 21st for Matthews Wells, 22nd Mark Silas, 23rd Tim Renoff, 24th Jose Mills, and Diego Yepez in 25th, with Riley Sprotup in 26th. And then Jack Cameron and Ryan Brown both a lap down, 27th and 28th. Land Lyons goes five laps down at the end, ends up in 29th. And Mitchell Collins, the only truck to retire here tonight, ends up in 30th. A very crazy Eldora race. We never really got rhythm in this. We had two caution flags and kind of spread the race out a little bit. Didn't really get any green flag runs in here tonight. But now let's go see the point standings after Eldora. Here's how the points look after Eldora. We're getting oh so close to chase time, so these drivers know they need to be on their A game for the next few races. Jamie Stammer Jr. still on top of the points, now 15 ahead of Marshall Burrow, who is still second. Diego Yepez still in third, Ashton Boyd in fourth with that win here tonight, and moving up into the top five, Bobby Frazier in the 14. Michael Gregory is now sixth, seventh for Leon Campana, eighth Justin Zeidel, and Jose Mills in ninth, and Madison Tall, a great top five, moves her up inside the top 10. Anthony Harris currently 11th, 12th for Trey Rainey, Damian Blue 13th, 14th Danny Lloyd, and 15th for Devon Redd. 16th Mathis Wells, 17th Mitchell Collins, Tim Renoff in 18th, 19th Sebastian Kuechel, and Bronson Minnick rounding out the top 20. So currently, our two wildcard spots, Tim Renoff two wins down in 18th, but no other winners are 11th to 20th in points, which means the other wildcard goes to Anthony Harris, who is 11th in points, only 11 points outside of the top 10 by Madison Tall, and it's very close for the top 10 in points. Jose Mills only 1 point ahead of Madison Tall, so they're 9th and 10th. Anthony is only 11 points back at Tall, which means he's only 12 back of Jose Mills. Then Trey Rainey is only 13 back of Hernandez, which means he's not far back as well, and he's actually tied with Damian Blue, who's only one ahead of Danny Lloyd, who's tied with Devon Redd. So it's very, very close from about 8th to 15th in points. One small swing, one bad race could swing this points picture drastically. Even the points leaders, they're not that far ahead of drivers down like 15th in points. 15th in points, only 194 points back of the points leader. That could be two races worth of points. William Seaman down 21st, has one win, but needs to be top 20 in points. He's only 9 points back, again, a wildcard spot. 22nd, Alex Fletcher, 23rd for Jack Cameron, 24th, Mark Samson, 25th for Ryan Brommer. Walker Davis, 26th, Levi Jones, now 27th after missing the race here tonight. Casey Nacko, 28th, 29th, Danny Bright, he also missed the race. Same with the racer in 30th, Isaac Nichols, 31st, and 32nd for Riley Snare. For Riley Sprotup, it's been a bad season, a win earlier in the season, but that's been his only high points, his only top 10 this season, and he's behind all these drivers that have missed this race at Eldora. Same with Land Lyons in 34th, is actually below Riley Sprotup, and Premier McShane down 35th after missing here tonight. Still has that victory though, try and back her up. And then you have Colin Teague, Luis Ramirez, and Griffin Lynn splitting the one ride for the season. They're all down towards the bottom of the points. 13 races done with the Pennzoil Truck Series season number 7. Next race is going to be a fun one for sure. We're going, if you want to call it short track racing, call it intermediate racing. Be both as we go to the Iowa Speedway for the Krispy Kreme 250. I will see you guys then.